The pipes are coming. Oh, Jesus, fuck! Oh, gummy skin! She's peeling me what? Fucking skin! Fuck!
Was a weird year for many reasons. An orange guy became the president, a gorilla died, and it was also the year that the R rating in the US decided to reach its peak, with movies like Deadpool, Suicide Squad, Batman the Killing Joke, and many others. But there was one small R-rated animated film that was released during 2016, and that movie was Sausage Party. And if you know Sausage Party, you know how much the internet freaked out over the trailer. At first glance, it might seem like your typical cutesy CGI animated film from studios like Disney or Pixar or DreamWorks or Blue Sky. Oh, wait a minute. But on the inside, it's actually an R-rated animated comedy produced by Seth Rogen that contains swearing, violence, drugs, and even sex. I mean, it's not every day you hear a cute animated character from a movie burst out words like
Jesus fuck! Oh, gummy skin! She's peeling me what? Fucking skin! Fuck! Fucking children!
Oh, yeah, that's a good point. Fuck me, right?
We're super sure there's nothing shitty waiting for us in the great beyond!
Holy shit, I've been chosen!
How fucking great!
Let's be honest, folks, we do not get many animated films like this anymore. The film was directed by both Conrad Vernon and Greg Tiernan. Conrad Vernon previously worked at DreamWorks Animation, providing the voice of the Gingerbread Man in the Shrek franchise, and directing the 2009 film Monsters vs. Aliens, with Seth Rogen even making an appearance in the film as Bob, whilst Greg Tiernan was the founder of the Canadian animation studio Nitrogen Studios, who helped provide the animation for the film, as well as some other projects like Happily Never After, and the first few seasons of Thomas and Friends when they started to enter the CGI era. Oh, and Greg Tiernan and Nitrogen Studios will be very important later on in this video due to some, controversies surrounding the film, but we'll get to that later. The film premiered on August 12th, 2016, to a mostly mixed reception. Whilst people praised the voice casting and the story, most people weren't too happy that most of the humor relied on shock value, considering the entire point of the film was that cartoon feud you might see in a Disney film and now swearing, doing drugs, and engaging in sexual acts. But what do I think of this film? Well, let's find out, shall we?
Good luck! Have fun!
The story of Sausage Party goes like this. Food is alive in a supermarket. The customers in said supermarket do not know that the food is alive. The food in the supermarket believe that the customers are gods, and that they will take them to a wonderful place known as the Great Beyond, where they will live in perfect harmony and will finally be able to
and love, and fuck, and hug, and fuck, and feel, and fuck.
The foods also have to sing a song about the gods in the Great Beyond that is also composed by longtime Disney Renaissance composer Alan Menken. Yes, that Alan Menken, composer of such classic Disney animated films such as Beauty and the Beast, The Little Mermaid, and Aladdin. He composed a song for the horny sausage film that's rated R in the US and is produced by Seth Rogen.
Dear gods, you're so divine in each and every way, to you we pray.
Dear gods, we pledge our love to you forevermore.
One of these foods is a hot dog sausage named Frank, voiced by Seth Rogen, who's getting tired of hearing tales about the Great Beyond and decides to expose the truth behind its existence and decides to find out what really happens when food exits the supermarket. Which I'm pretty sure we already know already, considering we've already seen the trailer and we already do it every day in order to survive. There are also various subplots throughout the film, but they mostly stay in the same direction as Frank. The foods go on a journey, they meet some stereotypes, and they realize that everything is a lie and the foods are eaten by the humans. Eventually, they learn that the humans can actually be killed after Barry, a deformed sausage voiced by Michael Cera, killed a druggie after he somehow communicated with Barry via the use of bath salts. Eventually, this all culminates in a final battle between the foods and the humans, where the foods end up killing some of the humans, and they end up having gay sex. But that's not the end of the film yet, as they later learn that their entire existence is a lie, as they are actually cartoons portrayed by actors in a movie. And so they go through a portal and try to kill the creators. And that's it. We don't get to see what happens after they go through the portal, it just ends. So overall, the story of Sausage Party is kind of clever and creative. On to the animation now, because this will be very interesting. Now let's go on to the animation. The animation in Sausage Party is really good. It's got bright and vibrant colors to give off that Disney Pixar vibe, even though it clearly isn't a Disney Pixar film, as well as great uses of dramatic lighting, such as in the kitchen scene and the Saving Private Ryan parody scene. There's also one point in the film where they use 2D animation, which, I mean, it's fine, I guess. It's, not as good as the CGI, but still fine. The animators in the film really worked hard on this, which makes this a lot more sadder, as days after the film was released, controversy soon erupted about how they treated the animation department. And that's not often for a mature animated film to get into trouble. Coonskin was accused of being racist, the South Park movie caused a moral panic from parents who do not know any better, and the Aqua Teen Hunger Force movie was the cause of a bomb panic. No, that is not a joke! And hell, even Sausage Party themselves got into trouble a few times before the movie was even released, such as the Red Band trailer playing in front of Finding Dory, the movie almost receiving an NC-17 rating, which is the American 18 rating, if they kept the pubes on Lavash's ballsack in the orgy scene. Oh wait, did I mention the orgy scene? Yes, I did. Okay. As well as the film being rated negative 12 in France, which was criticized by Catholic French groups. But this particular one is the one controversy most people talk about when they talk about Sausage Party. What was it? Well, behind the scenes of the film, some animators at Nitrogen Studios were allegedly mistreated by one of the film's directors, Greg Tiernan, and were forced to work overtime for no pay, and if they complained about it, they would be blacklisted and be uncredited from the film and fired from Nitrogen Studios. What the fuck? Transition aside, let's talk about the characters, starting with our main guy, Frank, who is a stand-in for people trying to expose religion for their practices. Oh yeah, did I mention that the film was an allegory for religion? Because it is. He's also trying to keep his relationship together with Brenda Bunsen, his hot dog bun girlfriend voiced by Kristen Wiig. He also has a friend named Barry, voiced by Michael Cera, and Carl, voiced by Jonah Hill. Spoiler, he dies. Also, there are also lots of stereotype characters such as Sammy Bagel Jr., Kareem Abdul-Lavash, Teresa Del Taco, Firewater, and Mr. Grits, whose whole joke is that he hates crackers. Do you get it? It is like the food item that you eat, but made to sound like a racial slur. Also, there was an attempt to do like a main antagonist in the film with the Nick Kroll douche, and even though like he wasn't really needed it, I kind of got a few laughs from him. So overall, Sausage Party is a fun and comedic animated film that is also surprisingly smart with its religious message. Although, I am glad that we never really got a sequel, because let's face it, I'm pretty sure we all know what happened after they went through the portal. And with the addition of how they mistreated the animators, I don't think we'll be getting a sequel to Sausage Party anytime soon.